Welcome to Exams Daily YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see the daily current affairs of August 11 and 12, 2019. Before that, the Zorian subscriber Exams Daily YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and also do not forget to click the bell button to get updates from our YouTube channel. August 12, International Youth Day. The 12th August was first designated as the International Youth Day by the UN General Assembly in the year 1999. This day serves as an annual celebration of the role of young women and men as essential partners in change, and this day is an opportunity to raise awareness of challenges and problems facing the world's youth. 2019 theme of this day is Transforming Education. So here we can expect the question that the International Youth Day is observed on which date? And the answer is August 12. August 12, World Elephant Day. The World Elephant Day is being observed on August 12. On August 12, 2012, the World Elephant Day was launched to bring attention to the urgent plight of Asian and African elephants. So here we can expect the question, the World Elephant Day is observed on which date? The answer is August 12. One Nation, One Ration Card launched. The Union Minister of Consumer Affairs Ram Vilas Paswan launched the One Nation, One Ration Card, a Government of India initiative, and this enables the beneficiaries to procure ration from fair price shop across the country. So here we can expect the question, which minister launched the One Nation, One Ration Card scheme? And the answer is Union Minister of Consumer Affairs Ram Vilas Paswan. Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum in Punjab set record in footfall. The Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum in Punjab's Anandpur Sahib town is all set to find a place in the Asia Book of Records for becoming the most visited museum in the Indian subcontinent on a single day. With its name in the Asian Book of Records, it would be the third entry for this museum in the record book. So earlier, Virasat-e-Khalsa made it to Limca Book of Records in the February 2019 edition and India Book of Records. So here we can expect the question that the Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum is located in which state? And the answer is Punjab. Tansa, Tungareswar sanctuaries are declared as eco-sensitive zones. The Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change declared the areas around Tungareswar and Tansa wildlife sanctuaries in Maharashtra as eco-sensitive zone. The basic aim of this is to regulate certain activities around the national parks and sanctuaries to minimize negative impact on fragile ecosystem around. So here we can expect the question, the Tungareswar wildlife sanctuary situated in which state? And the answer is Maharashtra. Chhattisgarh government to launch free food scheme to combat malnutrition anemia. The Chhattisgarh government has announced that it is going to launch a scheme that will provide free nutritious food to those that suffer from malnutrition and anemia in the state on a daily basis. The scheme would first be launched on October 2nd, the 50th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, and would extend to the 10 aspirational districts in the state. So here we can expect the question that which state government is to launch free nutritious food scheme to combat malnutrition anemia? And the answer is Chhattisgarh. Pink bollworm pest appears in cotton in Telangana districts. The dreaded cotton crop pest, pink bollworm, has made its appearance in some fields near Ponnari village in Thamsi Mandal of Adilabad district, Telangana, galvanizing the agriculture scientists to initiate measures to control its spread. And this pest can be controlled by setting up of pheromone traps, manually destroying the infested rosette flowers, and judicious use of neem seed kernel extract as pesticide at this stage. So here we can expect the question that which crop is being affected by pink bollworm pest? And the answer is cotton crop. Jana Small Finance Bank Limited announced that it has got the status of scheduled bank from RBI. The Bengaluru headquartered bank was established as a financial services company in 2009. The bank's aim has always been to provide financial inclusion to the underserved section of the society. So here we can expect the question that which small finance bank recently received scheduled bank status from RBI? And the answer is Jana Small Finance Bank. Third International Electric Vehicle Conclave. The Minister of State for Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises Arjun Ram Meghawal inaugurated the third International Electric Vehicle Conclave at the International Centre for Automotive Technology in Manesar, Gurugram. The conclave was held to create a knowledge-sharing platform to ensure the flow of information at all levels in the automotive sector. So here we can expect the question that the third International Electric Vehicle Conclave was inaugurated in which city? The answer is Gurugram. PM Kisan Mandan Yojana. The scheme has been envisioned with an aim to improve the life of small and marginal farmers of the country. The scheme is voluntary and contributory for formers in the entry age group of 18 to 40 years, and a monthly pension of Rs 3000 will be provided to them on attaining the age of 60 years. And the farmers will have to make a monthly contribution of Rs 55 to Rs 200 depending on their age of entry in the pension fund till they reach the retirement date, that is the age of 60 years. The central government will also make an equal contribution of the same amount in the pension fund. The spouse is also eligible to get a separate pension of Rs 3000 upon making separate contribution to the fund. And the important note is the Life Insurance Corporation of India shall be the pension fund manager and responsible for this pension payout. So here we can expect the question that who will be the pension fund manager and responsible for pension payout for this PM Kisan Mandan Yojana? And the answer is Life Insurance Corporation. 66th National Film Awards for 2018. Gujarati film Hellaro was declared Best Feature Film winner, while Badai Ho bagged the award for Best Popular Film Providing Wholesome Entertainment. Hindi movie Padman was declared Best Film on Social Issues, while Kannada film Ondalla Eradalla got Nargis Dutt Award for Best Feature Film on National Integration. The Bollywood stars Ayushman Khurrana and Vicky Kaushal have jointly bagged the National Film Award for Best Actor for their roles in Annadadun and Yuri. Actor Kiti Suresh won the Best Actress Award for her portrayal of Esther Year star Savitri in Telugu film Mahanadi. So here we can expect a question that which film was declared as Best Feature Film in 66th National Award, and that is Gujarati film Hellaro. World Archery suspends AAI for defying guidelines. The World Archery suspended the Archery Association of India for defying its guidelines by electing two parallel bodies, asking the federation to put its house in order by the end of this month. So this decision is effective from August 12 onwards, and the last event in which the archers can participate under the Indian flag is the World Archery Youth Championship in Madrid from 19th to 25th of August. So here we can expect the question that World Archery Youth Championship is going to be held in which country? And the answer is Spain. Next, we can see the important current affairs of the year 2019. First question, who was honored with the highest decoration Zayed Medal by UAE? The answer is Narendra Modi. Second question, which telescope was used to discover the new exoplanet named TOI 197.0? The answer is TESS. Third question, who became the Slovakia's first female president? The answer is Susana Kapitova. Fourth question, when is Utkal Divas celebrated? The answer is April 1. Fifth question, India's longest suspension bridge, Maitri Bridge, was constructed over which river? The answer is Indus. We have also given the quiz link. If you want to attend this daily current affairs quiz, you can use that link. Hope this will be useful. Thank you.